Hello and welcome to pdfsupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an IC660BBD101 genius block. This is a 115 volt AC, 8-point input output discrete block. Basically this test is to do some troubleshooting and make you guys understand how to completely test this block, every function. So a few things that I have here peripherally that you guys are going to need. Of course, the first thing would be an IC660HHM501 handheld monitor, which I have plugged into the monitor port on the Genius block. I also have an IC693BEM331 Genius bus controller, which is plugged in right here through my serial 1, 2, and my shield. And a power cord, 115 volt AC. I have my hot lead going to where it says H, indicated on the door here, and my neutral lead going in to where it says neutral. Okay, now I also have connected to this, and I'm going to bring this into the camera just for a second, a mechanics drop light. My neutral lead from the drop light is connected right next to my neutral lead from my power input, and what I'm going to use that for is to test our outputs. So every time I touch the probe of the hot lead from the light to the inputs, I should be getting a response. Basically, the light should light up. All right, that's an easy way to test it. Okay. And the other thing is I have a probe that I have set up here just for the inputs. Okay, it's just a raw probe, one wire on one end and a probe on the other end, and we'll pick up our hot lead for that and touch the inputs. Another thing that you'll notice is that I have a piece of electrical tape that I like to put over my neutral leads. That way I don't inadvertently short out anything, okay? I recommend that you guys do that just so you don't accidentally go past input number 8 and maybe create a short. That would be a big problem. Now, what you can't see on the camera right now is that I have an IC693CHS3975 slot rack, which is featuring a IC693PWR330 power supply and an IC693CPU374+ processor, and as I mentioned before, the Genius bus controller. You can use different processors, different power supplies, it doesn't really matter, but the reason that I have this set up is because we're also going to be using Proficy Machine Edition to make sure that the Genius block's function of the serial port is working between the software and the processor, okay? So because of that, what we're going to do is a couple things. First thing we want to do is establish the Genius block. All right. Now, normally these are set at 153.6K standard baud rate. That's the factory setting. So I'm going to select OK. If you have a different setting, you can toggle it to a different setting if you have it at 153.6 extended and so forth. I'm going to go to configuration, F3. And before I do that, actually, I'm going to go to F1, handheld monitor, F1 again, handheld monitor configuration. Next. I want to make sure that we are all on the same page and that your host should be series 90. All right, and I'm going to toggle around so you can see that there's different series that you can choose. But we're going to use series 90 for this test, okay? I'm going to go back to home, configuration, F3, program block ID, F1. Okay, so it's currently configured as input output 1 through 8, and it's block number 1. Block number 1 is fine to begin this test. We're going to go to reference F1, enter, 1, enter, and we're going to toggle this input output mode to just strictly input. And we're going to test the inputs first, so enter. And then it configures it. Go back to home, F3 configuration, F2 configure block. Now we want to make sure that our settings are set up so that it doesn't inhibit the test. Another thing is this configuration protect. You're not allowed to edit or make any changes to the programming of the Genius block unless this is in the disabled function. However, if you do need to have it set up a certain way, you need to protect your block, you can always toggle to enable the protection. Okay, but in this particular case, as we're testing, we're going to leave that alone. We're going to go back to Home and Analyze F1 Monitor Block. We're going to stop right there for a second and jump into Proficy Machine Edition. Proficy Machine Edition, this is going to be part of the test. So as I mentioned before, the PWR330, CPU374, and the BEM331, I have this all set up in my rack right here. This is for a Genius block test. And I've got the tab open for the IC693BEM331. I'm going to go to Global Data. As I mentioned before, our bus address number for this block is number 1. So you can double click on where it says generic, where I've got my arrow, or you can right click and hit data entry tool. And it's 8 discrete input, so 8% I, okay. And it'll automatically establish a input starting address, which in my particular case is 113. Yours might be 0001, okay. Just check to make sure you know where your address is so you can look at where the inputs are going to be coming in. And now if you look down below, my status of the processor right now is programmer mode. It's stopped, meaning not in run mode. Inputs and outputs are disabled, and the configuration and logic are not equal. All right, so what we're going to do in that case is go to target, online commands, clear, controller and IO fault tables. All right, you want to do that to make sure we don't get hung up when we do this part of the download and start active target. So for this test, it's just going to be hardware configuration and motion and logic. We don't need to write anything to permanent flash memory. Select OK. And enable the outputs. Yes. Okay. Now at this point, you should be programmer mode, run enabled, configuration equal, logic equal. And your processor should have all three lights on, or rather, the processor should be reporting to the power supply to be in run mode. All right. Now the next thing I'm going to do, since I'm in Proficy Machine Edition, is go down to my default tables and expand that. Go to my inputs, and I'm going to bring my arrow over here to where our inputs are going to be coming in. All right, at the tip of my arrow, you can see it's as I'm hovering over it, it says percent 00113. So that's where I'm going to start to look for my input activity. We're going to toggle these zeros to ones by probing. All right, now back to the Genius block. What I'm going to simply do is take the raw end of the wire of the probe and just touch it to my hot lead. Now notice, once that's touched, this is now live. I have 115 volts at the tip of this probe. So be careful, don't touch it yourself with it. You can always screw this down on here, but I prefer to have it loose. Just so that I couldn't inadvertently shock myself. Then I'm going to start to probe these inputs. 1, 2. Now I'm looking for three things. I'm looking for activity in Proficy Machine Edition. I'm looking for activity in the handheld monitor. What I'm going to do is I'm actually going to probe one of the channels so that you guys are able to see what that should look like. You'll notice my number 2 is switched to a 1. My number 3 is switched to a 1. So it goes from a 0 to a 1, indicating that the input is activated. Okay, and then the third place, of course, is just simply the LEDs that are on the block itself. For user reference, that tells you that the input is activated. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, simple. Next thing, in the handheld monitor, I'm going to go back to Home, F3 for configuration, F1 for program block ID, F1 for reference, enter, 1, enter, and then toggle F2 to output. Okay, you should have the Q there, and we hit enter. It's going to ask you to wait while it configures all 8 outputs. Great. So the next thing is we're going to go back to home, F2 for analyze, F2 for monitor and control. And we're going to start to toggle all of these outputs on by selecting F2 for on, and then F1 to arrow to the next output, output number 2, on, output number 3, on, F1 for the next one, F2 for on, output 5, 7, and 8. Okay, so that's pretty easy. Now, again, same thing, we're looking for all the outputs to be on. And in order to do this test, this is back to where I mentioned I have a drop light. Here's my hot lead from the drop light, and here's my neutral lead from the drop light. So I've already picked up the neutral. Now I just need to simply tap. Each input. I think you guys can probably see this going on and off, but I'll just show you anyway. Okay. Now, just as important, I need to release all of these. So what I'll do is take the handheld monitor, hit F4 for release, F1 for the next one, F4 for release, next, release, F1 for next, F4 for release, and so on until all of my outputs are off. Okay? So everything's off right now. And what I want to do is I want to go ahead and redo that test and make sure that the outputs are not still stuck on. Okay? My lights are off, my outputs are off inside the handheld monitor, but you never know. If there's a circuit that's blown, it may indicate that it's off, but it's really stuck on in the on position. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. And also sometimes I'll test my light to make sure I'm getting an accurate reading. But otherwise this block is perfect. I'm able to program it is the first important thing. I know that my serial communication is working, serial 1, serial 2, through the Proficy Machine Edition and through the Genius Bus Controller, so that's perfect. Handheld monitor is working, it's plugged in, it's responding. All of my inputs are working and all of my outputs are working. So this is a perfect block. What I would recommend is that if it fails in any of those areas, it's a block that either needs replacement or repair. IC660BBD101 is a block that we very commonly repair here at PDF Supply. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products, and same-day shipping. So if that's something that you need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.